In the last couple of videos, we talked about the definitions of linear combinations, linear independence, and spanning in general. Now let's talk about what that means for vectors in Euclidean space, in Rm. And I'm going to call it Rm rather than Rn because we're going to take a collection of n vectors in Rm. And so you can think of those, each vector in Rm is a column with m entries. And if you lay them side by side, you can think of your n vectors as being the columns of an m by n matrix. So whenever somebody gives you a collection of n vectors, you can think of it as being related to a matrix where these are the columns. So now let's see what it means for those vectors to be linearly independent and for those vectors to span. And we'll start with linearly independent. If those vectors are linearly independent, the definition is that the only way to get zero as a linear combination is if all of the coefficients are zero. So the only way to get zero is x1, b1 plus xn, bn is if all of the x's are zero. But ax is a linear combination of the columns with coefficients being x1 through xn. So that's another way to say that is the only solution to ax equals zero is x equals zero. And we've gone over the theory of how do you find all the solutions to ax equals 0. You row reduce. And you get non-trivial solutions if you have free variables. So you have only the trivial solution if there's a pivot in each column. And if you if you have too many vectors, if you have more vectors than the size of your space, like if you have 5 vectors in R4, then this can't happen. You can't have a pivot in each column because you can have at most m pivots and you have n columns. If it's a big enough space, if you have, say, 4 vectors in R5, then it might happen that you have a pivot in each column, or it might not. You have more work to do. Okay, that's linear independence. Now let's talk about spanning. The vectors span Rm if every vector in Rm can be written as a linear combination of them. Well, that means every vector can be written as ax for some x, because the x's are the coefficients, and the columns of A are the vectors that you're taking linear combinations of. Well, that means that no matter what vector you pick in Rm, you can find a solution to ax equals b. A solution to ax equals b is a way to write B as a linear combination of the columns of A. And we know when that happens, you can always find a solution if there's a pivot in each row. And once again, if you have a tall and skinny matrix, that can't happen. You can have at most one pivot in each column, but then there's some rows left. If you have more rows than columns, you can't have a pivot in each column. If you have a short and fat matrix, you might have a pivot in each column, or you might not. You have to do more work to tell. Okay, so let's see what happens if there's a summary. We're talking about n vectors in Rm. If you have lots of vectors in a small space, like 5 vectors in R4, they must be linearly dependent. You cannot find 5 linearly independent vectors in R4. If you have four vectors in R5, they can't span. If you don't have enough vectors, you can't span. It takes at least m vectors to span Rm. And that means, and if there are exactly the right number of vectors, then you have to look at the rank of the matrix. If the rank of the matrix is too small, if it's less than n, you don't have enough pivots to fill up the columns or the rows. So then the vectors are linearly dependent and they don't span. Or if the rank is equal to n, you have one pivot for each column and one pivot for each row. Well, then they're linearly independent, they span, and they form a basis. And by the way, this says that every basis has exactly m vectors. It can't have more than that, or else they would be linearly dependent. can't have less than that or else they wouldn't span. So all bases have the same number of vectors. All bases for Rm have m vectors. And we said that the dimension of Rm is m. So dimension is the same thing as the number of vectors in a basis.